This is Mission Control Houston. Just to recap activities of the week aboard the International Space Station, a team of flight controllers that has been led much of the week by Flight Director Ed Van Sice, watching over his team throughout the daytime hours of the International Space Station as the International Space Station circles the Earth every 92 minutes at an altitude of about 250 miles, supporting the Expedition 31 crew of Oleg Kononenko from Russia, Andrei Kuipers from the Netherlands, and U.S. astronaut Don Pettit as they complete their four-and-a-half-month stay aboard the International Space Station. It's been a busy week for the crew as they have been spread throughout the 32,000 cubic feet facility, conducting science investigations, preparing for the arrival of three new crew members and the first ever commercial cargo spacecraft, and routine housekeeping chores. Earlier this week, the crew began packing items for their return to Earth aboard Space Exploration Technologies' Dragon spacecraft. In and around the conduct of science investigations, that pre-pack of about 1,000 pounds of equipment was completed Thursday, and Dragon now sits atop a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket at the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida, awaiting launch scheduled for 3:55 in the morning Central Time, 4:55 Eastern, next Saturday, May 19th. The crew also conducted training exercise this week with Mission Control, demonstrating their ability to follow procedures and respond to scenarios associated with a sudden depressurization of the cabin atmosphere. The training is conducted periodically to ensure the crew and flight control teams are ready to respond in the event of a similar real issue aboard the station. Pettit and Kuipers had a unique opportunity earlier in the week also to discuss their mission with the World Wildlife Fund annual global conference that was taking place in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. The WWF is one of the world's leading conservation organizations, working with more than 100 countries. Midweek, the focus was on unloading of cargo delivered aboard the ESA automated transfer vehicle, Eduardo Amaldi. That transfer activity continues throughout the week. Thursday, Don Pettit performed a unique experiment testing the properties of flame on various types of products to help investigators determine the burning and extinguishing characteristics of a wide variety of samples. He continues that experiment at the end of the week, and they also conducted, along with his other colleagues, other experiments, including measuring changes in energy balance to help determine energy needs for astronauts over long-duration space flights, and also develop an equation for energy needs of crew members in the future. Threaded throughout the week, the crew continued unloading the ATV and Russian Progress supply vehicles. The 47 Progress unloading was completed midweek, and the loading of unneeded items began ahead of its departure. The crew will spend the weekend for the most part off-duty conducting routine housekeeping chores, including exercise and Earth observation, and also talking with their families. They will, however, keep an eye on preparations for launch of their newest crew members' arrival next week. The Soyuz TMA-04M is set to launch Monday night at 10:01 Central, 11:01 p.m. Eastern Time, delivering Gennady Padalka, Sergey Revin, and Joe Acaba to the station next Wednesday. Their preparations and those of their rocket and spacecraft are going well, with integration scheduled Saturday and rocket roll to the launch pad on Sunday. So it's been a busy week for the Expedition 31 crew, with another exciting week ahead as well, with the launch of the Soyuz spacecraft, and then next Saturday, the launch of the SpaceX Dragon cargo vehicle to the International Space Station. NASA TV will begin covering the Soyuz launch Monday night at 9 p.m. That will be some bonus coverage with our additional to our usual hour of coverage that occurs in the morning at the 10 a.m. Central, 11 a.m. Eastern time.